So, status 456, the series where I talk about random things that I do. So, I've passed 4 out of 5 final exams, and I just gotta retake maths near the end of February. College has been kind of fun, but also kind of boring, at least when it comes to lectures and stuff like that, but it's just my first semester, so I'll kind of deal with it. Now, college hasn't impacted my schedule as much as I thought it would. I've still managed to release a couple of new videos, and I'm not feeling any pressure, so that's good. And here are my plans for the near future. I recently bought a laptop, installed Linux Mint on it, and it's a fine little machine. This means I can finally do a video about Half-Life SDK on Linux. While it's admittedly a little clickbaity, it's technically true. Recently, I managed to set up Diligent Engine, or Diligent Core, or whatever you want to call it, to render a wibbly-wobbly pentagon in a window. What started off as a simple test app got ported to my Linux laptop and Half-Life SDK soon after. Now here's the thing, Gold Source uses something called immediate mode. That's when the CPU sends data to the GPU every frame. In other words, if you want to render a character model with 500 triangles, you gotta upload all that data every time you want to render it. This means you can get as low as 60 FPS on the 3090 and an i7 on some custom maps. It would be much faster if the renderer was rewritten to use retain mode, where the render data lives in video memory, because GPUs have quite a bit of it nowadays, and the CPU just tells the GPU to render that. Now obviously that's just a gross oversimplification, but you get the idea. Now I could just do that with a couple of OpenGL extensions, but I want to see if I can bring an entirely different rendering API too. We'll see where this goes, and then I might as well continue my series about modern OpenGL in Half-Life. Ideally, I would have to destroy the game window and then rewrite the renderer to render everything into that. So yeah, it's gonna be a lot of work to do. Now, ADM, short for Advanced Development Mod, is my mod base for Half-Life. I started working on it in 2018 when I was also starting to seriously learn C++. Obviously this led to a lot of poor design decisions and lots of messy code, because I was just a beginner, you know? This year I am rebooting the project with Half-Life Unified SDK as the base, and that means I'll have native Linux support and a bunch of other nice things. Currently I gotta port some map entities back and I can go for a first release. Then I'll bring back the features that made ADM what it was, high quality audio for instance. Having mentioned the Unified SDK, I'm gonna make a video about it one day. One of the cool things about it is not having the big bool data type. Instead, now you can use the C++ bool and save or store variables and many more. It's just amazing. I know some of you, like myself, are TrenchBroom enjoyers, but to be honest, it's missing a few critical features to make Half-Life mapping as comfortable as it would be in Hammer. It made me so sad, I decided to implement some of those myself. Currently, I have one pull request under GitHub, and I might do some more in due time. So yeah, that's about it for now. I could have talked about all these in detail, but the video would have been super long, and while I would love to just talk for 2 hours straight, I'm certain most of you would just fall asleep. It's not a bad thing though, I often watch videos with great technical detail and explanations, and I just fall asleep halfway through. It's just, sometimes it's just the way I sleep. Sometimes. With that said, if you found any of these topics pretty interesting or intriguing or completely asinine, which in translation means incredibly stupid, just ask me in the comments and we could discuss them. So yeah, see you all soon.